Super. You are full of energy now? Kind of, eh? Well, we're gonna make together, we're gonna see how to make a beautiful tart au citron, or otherwise, lemon tart. So, before we start, I want to ask if everyone has a recipe. If someone is missing a recipe, please raise your hand and our maitre d' will go around with the recipes. There we go. So, second question. Have you ever tried to make a lemon tart before? No? Some of you maybe? Well, I must tell you, the recipe we have here is very, very simple. It's very, very tasty. And actually, we're going to have good fun with it, okay? So, to start with, well, I will need some help. You know something? I'm gonna take our sexy assistant, Manuel, to help me today. How about that, yeah?
Come on, plenty of people here.
You don't want to come? You will not have lunch, dinner,
Okay, I'll do it.
So, before we start, one more time, anyone missing recipes? We have recipes? Recipe? Okay, perfect. So, Manuel. Please come. It's very easy. I will explain you everything.
Where is the pastry?
You are the pastry chef now. So are you ready? Mentally and physically? Yeah? So I have gloves for you there. So you can wear the gloves. Surgery, exactly. So you need to be quick, okay? Very nice, yeah, okay. Don't get too excited, okay? So, yes, we need to finish, not tomorrow, today, yeah? Very good. Good start. So, what we're going to show you here, we're going to show you how to make the pastry, how we're going to make the filling also, okay? We have our sexy assistant here, Manuel. So, we're going to start with our pastry first, okay? So to make a tart, we need always three basic ingredients. Help me here. What we need?
Flour.
Perfect. Eggs. Correct. And?
Butter.
Okay, when you want to make a tart, you need these three basic ingredients. Here we're going to use also sugar because we're going to make a nice sweet tart. But if you want to make, for example, a quiche lohan, you don't use any sugar. You use flour, butter, and eggs. Okay? For the recipe, I'm gonna use only unsalted butter, okay? Unsalted butter, very important. And also, the flour we are using is all-purpose flour, okay? So, we're gonna start first of all with our paste, as I said. So now what we're gonna make here, Manuel?
Sorry.
Yes, please.
If I'm gonna do it, I have to do it
well. Now,
yes, I can do it.
You look fantastic.
Thank you. More sexy than ever.
So, okay, you feel better now?
Well, I feel the power.
So now, what I want from you, Manuel, I want you to mix here, on top here, 50 grams of sugar. Yeah. Voila. Then we're going to put 100 grams of flour. Very well. Mix these two ingredients first, please. Try not to make a big mess.
No,
I know it's not easy. Fantastic. And now what I want you to do is also add there 100 grams of butter. Here it is. Yes. The butter we're going to use here is in room temperature, okay? So it's quite soft. You have gloves, you can use your gloves, yeah? Very well. So, and now, what you're going to do, you're going to mix by hand, okay? What you're going to create now is a crumble. What are you doing?
Mixing.
He's mixing.
Mixing.
Very well, that's it. Let's go.
It's like a blast.
You need to show that you're enjoying what you're doing, right? Smile.
He's really enjoying that.
Yeah, oh, yes.
A little too much.
I must tell you that, of course, you can use an electric mixer, yeah? But this is much more fun, yeah?
I'm electric.
Actually, you're doing a fantastic job. How come? That's okay. So now, exactly, you make a small, well, mountain. Let's put it like that. Make a small, yeah?
Volcano.
Volcano. Make a small hole in the middle. Okay, whatever. Now we're gonna crack one egg inside. No, no.
Okay.
You can see he's an experienced cook.
Okay.
You crack one egg. Yeah, exactly. No surface. Yeah!
Thank you.
Yeah. Super. And now you mix again. The egg is running out.
Why don't we put it inside of this?
Because we're going to need this for something else afterwards.
Okay.
It's more fun to see that, actually.
Ah, yeah.
It's sticky, right?
Yeah.
Well, exactly. It's quite sticky because you have the butter at the room temperature. Now we add the egg also. But slowly, slowly, you're going to see it's going to come together. Slowly, slowly, it should be in around 2-3 minutes, but with Manuel, maybe half an hour.
I want to do it properly.
I can see, yes, of course you want to do it properly. Now, as you can see, it's quite sticky, so that's why it's good to have a little bit of extra flour on the side. Throw on your hands. Rub your hands. Yeah, rub them. Actually, I should not give you any gloves, it would be more fun.
But if you are alone?
If you are alone?
You put the hand inside?
No, you put a little flour in a cup and you take it from the cup. Okay?
Okay, okay. That is gonna be a disaster.
You see? It's coming.
Yeah, it's
good. Try to create a ball, yeah? My God.
Okay, we gotta start again.
No, no, it's okay. You're doing well.
Slowly, slowly. Okay.
May I ask you something?
Yes, please.
Why are you pushing it down?
I don't know.
May I?
Yes, of course. You are the chair.
But I think it's in the most difficult part, right? So, we have our beautiful dough now. Very, very important. We have it ready. What we need to do, we need to let it rest, okay? And what we're going to do, we're going to wrap it in plastic wrap, okay? And then we're going to put it in the fridge for 20 to 30 minutes. This is the difference when you are making a tart. Because we have butter in the dough, we want actually the dough to become even more hard, because it's much easier to work with it afterwards. Now we're going to demonstrate, not pizza, eh? We're going to demonstrate how it's going to be if you don't let it rest. It's not going to be easy at all, believe me. Why you took out your gloves?
Ah, it's not done?
Put it back. So, as I said, very, very, very important part of the recipe. Let it rest for 20 to 30 minutes in the fridge, okay? And then you're going to have ready the dough to work with. Now, you can take out this one.
Yep.
We have another one here for you. Clean.
That's
here, this we'll be using here, it's called silicone pads. If you have them home, use them. If you don't have them, you don't need to go and buy them, okay? It's quite expensive, not a cheap item to have. But whatsoever, it's very helpful for rolling doughs and etc. Baking stuff on it also. So, beautiful stuff. I have this for you. Now, when you're gonna roll any dough, it's good to put a little bit of flour.
Chef, can I help a little bit with the flour? Because I just wanna, you know, I'd like to.
Let me go away though.
Put a bit of.
Nothing. Come on, let's start shaking. It's.
It's past time. Don't let him go inside the kitchen, please.
Andre, where's the parcel? Very excited after.
Now you look like a pastry chef.
No, this is enough on your face. And this is it.
You look good, man. So we put a little bit of flour on our rolling pin, okay? Pay attention now, here we work.
Yes.
We are working here, okay? So now, stop. We're gonna go.
It's electric also.
My nephew is not, is more, what is this? Look what you did. Equal. Fantastic. Other side, exactly. You want a nice round tart.
Put your body on it, come on.
I'm very proud of you.
Thank you very much.
I know one thing.
What?
If I have to cook alone, I will not be in the gallery. No, actually, you did a good job, actually. Okay, you need to more, actually. We're going to put a little more flour. Okay. It depends how big is your tray. This also how big you're going to make your tart, how you're going to open it, how much you're going to open it. Okay, I have a question for you. Very good. You've done a fantastic job, actually. Now, here you can see it's quite sticky, okay? That's why it's good to let it rest in the fridge for 20-30 minutes, what we said before. Now, I think a question that all of you have. How are we going to put this on our pan, on our tray to bake it? Okay, we have many different options, okay? My option, and I think it's the easiest of all, what you do, you just roll it on the rolling pin. Can you help me here? I have one hand. There you go, you do like this, lift it, and then you roll it off. Okay, it's the easiest way to do it. So, now we have our tart ready. Now I'm going to show you how it's supposed to look, yeah? And voila. Okay. Let's fix it here. So this is how it's supposed to look, okay? This is our tart ready to be baked. So as you can see, we've made some holes on the tart, yeah? Why is that? Exactly. We don't want it to puff up. We want it nice and flat. We want a nice flat surface, nice crispy surface. So we got. What are you doing? Yeah, on the tray.
are we gonna use that one?
Well, okay. Forget about that. Okay. Let's clean. So now we're gonna bake it for 30 minutes, 300 Fahrenheit. Okay, we're gonna bake our tart and we're gonna have a beautiful golden tart. Yeah, beautiful, right? Listen to this, nice and crispy. Very nice.
It would be if it'd be standing in the fridge for 3 weeks. So it's okay.
You don't want to piss off.
I don't know, somebody's calling
you. Should I be honest?
It was baked this morning, you... I cannot say what I want now.
Say it Greek. Say it Greek.
He knows Greek also. You Malaka. So, fantastic job. So now we're gonna make our filling. So we're gonna make a lemon tart. So what we need?
Orange.
Orange. Lemons, right? We're gonna make a beautiful lemon tart. So we need fresh lemons. I had a question a couple of weeks ago. If it's necessary to use fresh lemons, or we can use ready lemon juice from a carton, what you can buy in the supermarket. My answer was simply like that. Better don't make the tart, okay? Always fresh lemon, yeah, it makes a big difference. So we're gonna use the zest from one lemon. The zest, I mean the yellow part of the lemon, gives this beautiful perfume to the custard what we're gonna make. And we're gonna use the juice of three lemons, okay? So I wrote in the recipe 155 milliliters, okay, of juice. Why? Because sometimes you have lemons very juicy, have big lemons, small lemons, and also having the quantity in the milliliters, you can also use limes. Yeah, you can make also a lime tart. And I must tell you, it is amazing. Fresh lime tart is amazing. Then you can make also an orange tart. Same thing, okay? So you can use whatever you like, but whatsoever, be careful with the milliliters, okay? So, lemon, you are confused.
Yeah. We need three lemons.
We need three lemons to squeeze. And the zest of one lemon.
Well, we have four.
I had one extra. So, where's the zest, please?
Where?
We have the microplane, and we're going to put it in our pot.
Don't put any glove in it, please.
Yes, please. Actually, now you can take out your gloves.
You told me before. I'm not going to take it out now.
Any questions so far? Something you would like to know, something to mention? Yes, please.
Why do you use unsalted butter versus salted butter?
Okay, the question is, so everyone can hear, is why I'm using unsalted butter versus salted butter. Well, for the custard what we're going to make, we don't need any salt at all, okay? Because it's gonna be nice and sweet. So that's the reason why we don't use salted butter. Now, for the tart, because in a point, in the recipe, we used one pinch of salt. So I can control how much salt I want. Otherwise, it's gonna be quite salty. It's very nice sometimes to have a salty, that to be nice and salty, and you have a sweet, a custard on the top, or if you have chocolate also, it's a nice combination. But you can use it, but sometimes you can lose the control, how much salt you want. Yes?
So if you don't have unsalted butter, can you use salted butter and eliminate the salt?
Well, whatsoever, if you use salted butter, you don't put any salt at all.
Okay.
But I would say that it's better to have unsalted butter, okay? Fantastic job. As you can see, Manuel did a great job finally. And he used only the yellow part, not the white part of the lemon, because the white part is quite bitter, okay? Now, very nice, you're gonna cut this and the two more lemons, please. Not your fingers, yeah?
I'm okay.
Actually, I will need your help now.
Easy.
No. So now we're gonna have two mixtures. We're gonna have the lemon juice with the lemon zest in our pot, and then we're gonna beat 4 eggs with 200 grams of sugar. Can you do me a favor?
Maybe eating the drums.
Yes, exactly. I need you to break 4 eggs. No shell, please.
I have a knife.
Have you ever cooked home?
No.
Have you ever tried to break eggs before?
Yes.
Where?
Before.
One time, this gentleman here, he put me boiled eggs. It was quite funny. We were breaking the eggs and saying,
yes, some showing here.
So now, 200 grams of sugar.
This man is putting good
eggs away. I like his style. Can you two please be a little bit organized? Jesus Christ, like kids.
You still haven't squeezed three lemons.
Yes. It's too hard.
Please. Squeeze. I'll squeeze.
Okay.
You eat.
Okay. Can you beat the eggs with the sugar, please? Yeah, but I need to be quick now, yeah? Quicker. No, really, I'm joking. Quicker. Chef, let's go have some coffee.
No.
Leave it back in 30 minutes.
What's food inside?
No.
Sweet.
From the lemon. Okay, really though, beat it. I'm not joking.
Put your body into it, come on.
What do you do?
Oh, really, man.
You can leave that sugar with the egg like this, it's gonna spit, so please. Look, she's showing you. Our guests are showing you how you're gonna have to do it. Exactly.
But they forgot the other part, speed.
Yes.
Tired. I have two
speeds.
It's one on the slope.
Two speeds. He has two speeds.
Speed one, speed two.
Two speeds. This one can be slow.
You are so confused, eh? Look.
Chef, you don't want to show it.
I want to show you. It's simple.
Take this. Take out the glove.
Okay.
Three.
It's hard.
You can always use a mixer, right? In the electric, no more. So, very, very important now. This is the most tricky, I would say, part of the recipe.
Beating.
So, now we're going to warm up our lemon juice with the lemon zest. And you can see where this is going. You're going to add the eggs with the sugar inside here. Very, very important. Do not let this boil, because when you add the eggs, you're going to have fantastic scrambled eggs.
That's right.
So we don't want that. So, now, please, you can add the eggs.
Slowly.
No, really, quickly.
And slowly.
Wow. As you can see, I will not stop stirring, okay? All the time. It's not necessary to do this one, yeah?
I'm using this, so...
Let me show you this. As you can see now, the mixture is very, very liquid. One more time. Yeah, very, very liquid. In a few minutes, you're going to have a nice, thick custard, yeah? You're going to understand when it's done. Straight away, you're going to get it nice and thick. When it becomes nice and thick, you're going to switch off straight the heat. Okay? And now, don't forget, we're not going to stop stirring all the time. Otherwise, again, we're going to have what? Scrambled eggs. Exactly. Not yet. The butter, when we have a nice thick custard, then we're going to add the butter. Do you have any questions? Something about Manuel? Yes, please. You could, but the thing is that the you don't have so much liquid inside. So that's why you don't do it. So, So now you can see the difference, please demonstrate. Yeah, beautiful. Now we can add the butter. Now, who says this is too much butter? We are not friends anymore. Yeah, it should be piece by piece. Well, if you think about it, you're gonna have one piece today, another piece the next day. It's okay. So, actually, what the butter gives is a beautiful aroma. I can smell it right now. And also, it gives this beautiful, nice glaze to the custard. And actually, would you like to try it from the pot as it is? Yeah? Please come along. I have spoons here for you. Please come and try it. Manuel? Yes, first. low temperature. You can feel this lemony, the intense lemony, but also the nice sweetness from the papa.
Hey, Carlos, I participated.
You said you
I think I can handle right here. What are you doing, man?
So we have our beautiful custard. Now, it's time to come on our top. Of course, we're going to scrape off what is left inside. You can eat this. So, just spread it everywhere. And we're going to bake it for one last time. 300 Fahrenheit for 30 minutes. And then you're going to have a beautiful result, a fantastic lemon tart. How was it?
Applause
for Manuel, first of all. So good, that's not right. Also, João Carlos de Pinto, our hotel manager. So Mike is doing nothing.
I'm going to participate in the eating. This is what I'm good at.
Well, thank you very much. Now our bar team will come and go around with some lemon tart. I think you'd like to try some, right?
Yes.
So our bar team will come around with some lemon tart. Bon appetit, enjoy. And what's going to happen after?
Well, ladies and gentlemen, as I mentioned, after this, we're going to have, so in about 5 minutes, they just need to remove this. And we're going to have a bit of a Q&A here with all the officers of the crew. So our hotel manager, Carlos, myself, our chef, Ricky, Mr. Emmanuel, Bianca will be here. And this morning, we'll actually have the participation of our operations manager, Ricardo Pipers. So if you have any questions, we'll just introduce ourselves briefly, just to break the ice a little bit. And then if you have any questions, just raise your hands, and I'll come to you with a microphone. So it's just a casual Q&A, all right? So I'll be very, very short.
So thank you very much. Bon appétit, enjoy. Thank you.